My own dear darling, so familiar face, that I do dream about by day and night. Do stroke it, and caress thy lips and cheeks. I love thy eyebrows that shape those orbs that I could stare at. Long, long minutes, hours, until thou so wearies to be adored. And love thy chestnut hair that tumbled free, for me to comb with my fingers eagerly. Kiss thy neck, my favorite special part. And for dessert, I'd nibble thy earlobe, that tiny silken pendant, a hanging peach. And now I'm so very close to thee, I have to trace thy jawline with my breath, until I reach those little pouty curves, those sweet ripe cherries I long to bite, thy lips that are so dangerous to me. And now so very close to thee, I have to visit thee, and knock upon thy door with my hot tongue, or let me in itself, I wish to play. The portcullis did open and in I leapt. Poor you, I could not leave you till I supped deep upon that potent heady wine. But I must your precious words conceal within my deepest and most secret butt, where no one but myself will ever claim, or stain with eyes and fingers, or will mock the letters they were never meant to read. For my Lord and my best love, the end of words, the holy book is closed. I love thee till it hurts too much to speak. I love thee as if my life was born for this. I love thee till the very end of time, or when they say our Savior comes again. The graves will open up and dead will rise, and even then I'll wait for my bold sire. And if we cannot speak again, just this, I'll know on earth I tasted sweetest bliss. Ophelia.
Dear love, is this the last I'll hear of thee? As I reluctantly depart these shores, I give these humble words to our dear boy, the messenger who, like a Mercury, doth fly betwixt you and me with lightning speed. And there he stands and patiently doth wait. As I do sadly write these final words, he glances down at me as if he reads our letters with his heart. For there they lay, since there he plants them safe within his vest, protecting them as if they were his babes. So now and just for now, farewell, my love, for I do love thee now and evermore. 'Tis said in ancient time that man and woman were united as one being, sharing heart and soul and blood in harmony, and that some ancient god did sunder us in anger for some sin. And since that day we have been crawling through the endless earth, searching most desperately for our lost half and pining in our lonely misery. For such a task is like the curse of Sisyphus, condemned forever to heave his mighty rock, which only tumbles down to where it was. So having found my perfect other half, I cannot bear to let thee go again. With thee I felt my heart and body sing with joy so rapturous. I'm sure God smiled to see two lost souls once again unite. And now I go, I'm so sick at heart. I kiss you tenderly and hold your head between my hands, and pray it won't be long that we are far apart. I will come back, since you possess my love, half of my heart. Hamlet.
On eagle's wings, carry my frenzied words. Deliver them to him, my eternal love. Then wait for him to give thee back his words. Oh, I'm so very weak at heart. The days are like lost worlds in which I breathe to no avail and have no taste to eat, but seek only forgetfulness and peace. And the morning's light is just a bitter curse, and then pray for darkness and deep dreams, and in that hopeful world you will appear and keep me company. A valiant wish. And when my darling does appear, I hate the morning light that melts my love away. And now wish the precious living hours gone, since they are dead in absence of love that keeps my purpose in this world alive. But now I fear my candles growing dim. It wanes for want of thy sweet living breath. O Hamlet, I'm not afraid to die. For in that sleep of death, what dreams may come. Remember when you spoke those words to me? And since you visit me only in my dreams, it may be there that we shall meet again. Ophelia.